Have you ever wondered what is the world's fastest and most powerful interceptor aircraft? This video will explore the Mikoyan Mig-31, a supersonic fighter jet that the Soviet Union developed to defend its airspace from any threat. We will examine its history, features, radar, weapons, and variants and see why it is still in service today. The Mig-31 is a long-range, two-seat supersonic interceptor aircraft that can fly at speeds of over Mach 2.8 and altitudes of up to 25 kilometers. It has an advanced radar system that can detect and track multiple targets at long distances and a formidable arsenal of missiles that can engage air and ground targets. It also has unique capabilities, such as launching anti-satellite weapons and hypersonic missiles. The Mig-31 is based on and shares design elements with the Mig-25, an earlier interceptor designed to counter the American XB-70 Valkyrie bomber project. However, the Mig-31 is much more than a simple upgrade of the Mig-25. It is a new design that incorporates many improvements and innovations. The Mig-31 has several variants and upgrades produced or proposed over time. Some of these variants have different roles or capabilities than the original model. For example, the Mig-31M is a more advanced version with improved avionics and weapons. The Mig-31D is a dedicated anti-satellite model with a special missile. The Mig-31BM is a modernized multi-role version with upgraded radar and displays. And the Mig-31K is a modified version able to carry the hypersonic Kinzel missile. In this video, we will look at each aspect of the Mig-31 and learn more about this amazing aircraft. So buckle up and get ready for a thrilling ride. Let's first examine its history to understand how the Mig-31 came to be. The Mig-31 was developed as a replacement for the Mig-25, which was designed in the 1960s as a high-speed, high-altitude interceptor to counter the threat of the American XB-70 Valkyrie bomber project. The XB-70 was supposed to fly at speeds of over Mach 3 and altitudes of over 20 kilometers, making it invulnerable to existing Soviet interceptors and air defenses. However, the XB-70 project was canceled in 1969 after two prototypes were built and one crashed. The Mig-25, which had already entered service in 1970, was left without its main adversary. The Mig-25 was still useful as an interceptor against other Western aircraft, such as the SR-71 Blackbird reconnaissance plane and the B-1 Lancer bomber, but it had some limitations. It lacked maneuverability at interception speeds and was difficult to fly at low altitudes. It also had poor fuel efficiency and short range. Its radar was powerful but primitive, and its engines were vulnerable to damage if pushed beyond Mach 2.8. The Soviet Air Force realized they needed a new interceptor to overcome these drawbacks and cope with the evolving threats of low-flying cruise missiles and stealth aircraft. They also wanted an interceptor to coordinate with other aircraft and ground control centers using data links and advanced electronics. Thus, in 1971, they issued a requirement for a new long-range interceptor based on the Mig-25 but with significant improvements. The Mikoyan Design Bureau took up the challenge and began working on the Y-155MP prototype, which later became the Mig-31. The Y-155MP first flew on September 16, 1975, piloted by Alexander Fedotov, who later died in a crash while testing another prototype in 1984. The Y-155MP looked similar to the Mig-25, but it had a longer fuselage to accommodate a second crew member who would operate the radar and weapon systems. It also had many new features, such as digital flight controls, multifunction displays, phased array radar, data links, infrared search and track system, improved engines, stronger airframe, larger fuel capacity, and more versatile weapons. The Y-155MP proved successful in its test flights and impressed the Soviet Air Force with its performance. It set several world records for speed and altitude in 1977 and 1980. It entered operational service in 1981 under the designation Mig-31. It replaced the Tu-128 as the Soviet Union's dedicated long-range interceptor. It was deployed in large numbers across the vast Soviet territory, especially in the northern and eastern regions. It also participated in various conflicts and exercises, such as the Iran-Iraq War, the Afghan War, the Chechen Wars, and the Russian invasion of Ukraine. The Mig-31 was the last interceptor designed by the Soviet Union before its collapse in 1991. After that, the Mig-31 was inherited by the Russian Federation and Kazakhstan, which are still operating today. The Russian Air Force has about 130 Mig-31s in service and plans to keep them until at least 2030. The Kazakh Air Force has about 50 Mig-31s in service and plans to upgrade them to the Mig-31BM standard. The Mig-31 is also being developed into a new aircraft, the Mig-41, which is expected to enter service in 2025. Now that we have seen how the Mig-31 was developed, let's move on to its features. The Mig-31 is a large twin-engine aircraft with side-mounted air intake ramps, a shoulder-mounted wing with an aspect ratio of 2.94, and twin vertical tail fins. It has a length of 22.69 meters, a wingspan of 13.46 meters, and a height of 6.15 meters. It has a maximum takeoff weight of 46 tons and a maximum landing weight of 36 tons. The Mig-31 is powered by two Solovive D30F6 after-burning turbofan engines, each rated at 150 tkln lbs of thrust with an afterburner. These engines allow the Mig-31 to fly at speeds of over Mach 2.8 and altitudes of up to 25 kilometers. The Mig-31 can also fly at supersonic speeds without an afterburner, saving fuel and increasing range. The Mig-31 has a maximum speed of Mach 1.23 at low altitude and Mach 2.83 at high altitude. However, it can reach higher rates if necessary. But at the risk of damaging its engines and airframe, the Mig-31 has a large fuel capacity of 16.13 tons internally, plus optional external fuel tanks that can add another 5 tons of fuel. It also has an in-flight refueling probe that can extend its range even further. The Mig-31 has a range of 3,000 kilometers with 4 R-33 missiles and 2 drop tanks, or 5,400 kilometers with 1 aerial refueling. It has a combat radius of 1,450 kilometers at Mach 0.8 and 10,000 meters. The Mig-31 is not designed for close combat or rapid turning. Its wing loading is marginal while flying under combat weight, and its thrust-to-weight ratio is favorable. The Mig-31 is designed for long-range interception and high-speed chase. It uses its speed and altitude advantages to engage its targets before they can escape or retaliate. One of the key features of the Mig-31 is its advanced radar system, which was a game-changer in aerial warfare. The Mig-31 was the world's first operational fighter with a passive electronically scanned array radar, the Zaslin S-800. This radar could detect and track multiple targets at long distances in both look-up and look-down shoot-down modes. It could also scan multiple sectors simultaneously and switch between them quickly. The Zaslin radar had a maximum range of 200 kilometers against fighter-sized targets. It could track up to 10 targets and simultaneously attack 4 with its Vimpel R-33 missiles. The radar was paired with an infrared search and track system for passive detection and targeting. The radar also had various air-to-air and air-to-ground operation modes, such as mapping, terrain avoidance, target designation, and jamming resistance. The Zaslin radar was later upgraded to the Zaslin M version with improved range, resolution, and modes. The Zaslin M had a larger antenna with a diameter of 1.4 meters, which increased its performance by 50 to 100% compared to the original Zaslin. It had a search range of 400 kilometers for AWACS-sized targets and 282 kilometers for fighter-sized targets. It could track up to 24 targets simultaneously and engage up to 6 simultaneously. It also had a higher relative target speed detection of Mach 6 instead of Mach 5. The Zaslin M radar gave the Mig-31 an edge over other interceptors regarding situational awareness and firepower. It also enabled the Mig-31 to coordinate with other aircraft and ground control centers using data links and advanced electronics. The Mig-31 is fast, powerful, and well-armed, with various weapons for different scenarios. The main weapon of the Mig-31 is the R-33 long-range air-to-air missile, which can engage high-altitude and high-speed targets at distances up to 300 kilometers. The R-33 is a semi-active radar-guided missile with a speed of Mach 4.5 and a warhead of 47 kilograms. It is carried under the belly of the Mig-31 and for launchers. The Mig-31 can also carry other missiles, such as the R-37 and the R-77, and various anti-radiation, anti-ship, and air-to-ground missiles. The R-37 is an ultra-long-range air-to-air missile that can hit targets up to 400 kilometers. It is designed to intercept large, high-value targets such as AWACS, bombers, and cruise missiles. It has an active radar seeker and a speed of Mach 6. The R-77 is a medium-range air-to-air missile that can engage targets up to 100 kilometers. It has an active radar seeker and a speed of Mach 4. It can also perform high off-boresight attacks using its thrust vectoring control. The Mig-31 can carry up to 6 R-77 missiles on its wing pylons. The Mig-31 can also use various anti-radiation, anti-ship, and air-to-ground missiles for different missions. For example, it can carry the KH-31, a supersonic anti-radiation missile that can destroy enemy radars and air defenses. It can also take the KH-35, a subsonic anti-ship missile that can sink enemy ships and boats. It can also carry the KH-29, a laser-guided air-to-ground missile that can destroy tanks and bunkers. Some variants of the Mig-31 are equipped with a 23mm Gryazov Shipunov GSH-623M rotary cannon with 260 rounds for close-range combat. The gun has a rate of fire of 10,000 rounds per minute and can fire armor-piercing or high-explosive rounds. The gun is mounted on the right side of the fuselage near the air intake. Over time, several variants and upgrades of the Mig-31 were produced or proposed to enhance its capabilities and roles. The Mig-31M is a more advanced version of the Mig-31 developed in the late 1980s but has yet to enter service due to budget constraints. It had improved avionics and weapons systems, such as a new cockpit with color multifunction displays, a new Zaslin M radar with increased range and resolution, a new fire control system with increased target engagement capability, a new data link system with increased information exchange capacity, and new weapons such as the AR-37M and the AR-77M missiles. The Mig-31D. This is a dedicated anti-satellite model of the Mig-31 that was developed in the late 1980s but never entered service due to political reasons. It had a modified nose cone to accommodate a special missile called the 79M6 Contact, designed to destroy low-orbit satellites. The Contact missile had a kinetic kill vehicle to maneuver in space and collide with its target at high speed. The Mig-31BM is a modernized multi-role version of the Mig-31 developed in the late 1990s and entered service in 2011. It had upgraded radar and displays, navigation and communication systems, electronic warfare systems, data link systems, and new weapons such as the KH-31P anti-radiation missile and the KH-59 MiG-2 air-to-surface missile. The Mig-31K is a modified version of the Mig-31BM developed in the early 2010s and entered service in 2017. It can carry the KH-47M2 Kinzhal hypersonic missile, a modified version of the Iskander ballistic missile that can fly at speeds of over Mach 10 and maneuver in flight. The Kinzhal missile can hit targets up to 2,000 kilometers with high accuracy and penetration. The Mig-31 is an impressive aircraft that combines speed, power, range, and firepower. It is still one of the fastest and most capable interceptors today. It has also been adapted to carry new weapons, such as the anti-satellite and hypersonic missiles, that give it a unique edge in modern warfare. What do you think of the Mig-31? Do you like it or not? Do you have any questions or comments about it? Let us know in the comments section below. Thank you for watching, and remember to subscribe, like, or share this video if you enjoyed it. See you next time on Amazing Aircraft.